أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, my dear respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to what is right, show us truth as truth and help us to follow it, and show us falsehood as falsehood and help us to stay away from it. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. On this blessed day of Jumu'ah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower us with His protection, to grant us ease in these times of difficulties, and to grant us and our family Jannatul Firdaus. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. We were reflecting on the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu anhu reported that he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Messenger of Allah, which people are tested the most severely? And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they are the prophets, then the next best, then the next best. A man is tried according to his religion. If he is firm in his religion, his trials will be more severe. If he is weak in his religion, his trial is according to the strength of his religion. And the servant will be continued to be tried until he is left walking upon earth without any sins. As we said last week, that we will look into the lives of the prophets and messengers and look at the trials and tests that they went through and see some lessons we could extract from their lives so that we could put it in our lives as well. And today I will start with the very first man created, that is Prophet Adam alayhi salam. We're not going to go into the details of the story of Adam alayhi salam. Rather, we will jump directly to some of the lessons we learned from his life and how we can put those lessons, those valuable lessons, and practice them in our lives. The very first of the lessons that we can learn from the life of Adam alayhi salam is that Shaytan, Iblis, is our worst enemy. Right when Adam alayhi salam was created and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the angels along with the Iblis to bow down to Adam alayhi salam out of respect, Iblis said, I am better than him. And at that point, and from that point, rather, he took it an oath that he is going to distract mankind from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here we find that Adam alayhi salam and his wife Hawa, when they were put into paradise, when they were put in Jannah, there was a certain tree that they were forbidden from touching. However, Shaitan came after them until they ate from that tree. He did not start off by telling them directly they are going or go ahead and eat from that tree. Rather, he made that tree so appetizing, so tempting, that it led Adam alayhi salam and Hawa to eat from that tree. And this is something that we have to recognize, that our worst enemy is Iblis, is the Shaitan. And that is why when we ourselves, we get a thought, an evil thought, a temptation, and this is going to happen to each and every individual, we're going to be tempted with so many different things. From the point we get the thought, we should right away reflect upon that thought. Is it from Shaitan? Is it something that's going to bring me benefit? Or is it something that's going to bring me harm? And here we find that we have to be sincere about it. We have to be honest to ourselves. We cannot justify our actions because everyone else is doing it, that makes it right. No, we have to do what is right based on the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, based on the Quran and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yet another one of the lessons that we learn from the life of Adam alayhi salam is the importance of repentance. So after Adam alayhi salam and Hawa, they ate from that tree. They were tempted. They were led down the path to eat from it. They ate from it. And then they were sent into this world. When they committed that sin, they called out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. They accepted that they did something wrong. They cried out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they said that verily if you do not, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا, verily we have wronged ourselves. أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا, if you do not forgive us and have mercy on us, we'll be among the losers. The first thing they did was they recognized that they did something wrong. And they called out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in sincere repentance. And this is something for you and for I as well. is that when we do something wrong, we have to recognize that we have done something wrong. The very first step to that tawbah is to recognize that we have done something wrong and then turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for that forgiveness. Because the very opposite, which is arrogance, that we saw on the end of Shaitan, that we saw on the end of Iblis, we saw which path he led or he was led down because of his disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he did not recognize that he did anything wrong. Rather, he continued with that wrong, even asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for life till the end of time so that he could come and distract us from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So be sincere with our repentance, and at the same time, do not be arrogant when it comes to asking Allah, when it comes to reflecting on our mistake, when it comes to accepting that we have done something wrong. Let us not be arrogant about that. Another point we get is that we should have true faith and belief and hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, when Adam alayhi salam and Hawa was sent to this earth, it would have sounded to all of us that it is the most horrible disappointment that ever happened. And in spite of that, we could see some beauty in that, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a plan, which was that our race, the human race, would continue to inhabit this earth. And thus, here we are today, all because of the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, we're going through some trials and tests, but we go through the trials and tests in order for us to recognize when we are in happiness. See, if you are healthy your entire life and never witness a sickness, then you would never know what it means to be sick, or rather, you would not appreciate fully what it means to be healthy. And the same thing when it comes to the ongoing life of success and happiness. If there's no test and trial, then we would not really understand and appreciate what it really means to be happy. You see, when the angels ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why is He going to put this people, this human race on this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala simply said to them, قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This life that we have is a test. This life that we have is a test. And we are currently in an exam room going through these trials and tests. And it's never fun going through an exam, even in our school, even in our classes. It's never fun studying for it, but rather we love the results at the end of it. If we get an amazing grade, we're super happy, we're amazed, we're ecstatic. We go and brag to our friends and we say, you know, this is what I got, because we're happy after that test. After we have completed that test, we enjoy the victory, we enjoy the results from that test. And that is why when we read the life of Adam alayhis salam and he was put into this world, this was the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we will be on this earth and we will be tried through many ways as we are being tried at the moment in so many different ways. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us. So it is very important that we reflect on the lives of these prophets, because they were the ones that were tried the most. If we think we're going through some trials and tests, we will go through many of the prophets, as many as we could in this time period, and we will try to analyze what they went through and how they reacted. Here we saw Adam alayhis salam and Hawa. After they committed their mistake, they turned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are a few things we have to pay attention to. See, both Iblis and Adam alayhis salam, both of them, they committed a mistake. We could say they both sinned in a type of a way. Well, what was the reaction of them? You see, Iblis was devastated only because of the following. He did not confess his sin. He did not regret what he had done. He did not criticize himself for doing something wrong. He did not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he then lost hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whereas when we look at Adam alayhi salam, just at this part of his life, he found that happiness, he found that hope because he confessed that he did something wrong. He had a strong regret that he had done that wrong, because he said, if you do not forgive me and have mercy on me, if you do not forgive us and have mercy on us, verily we will be among the losers. And then he criticized himself for doing that wrong. He then turned and repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what truly brings about hope in each and every one of our lives. When we may think that we are being tested with so many trials and tests at the moment, yes, we're going through some type of test. Yes, on a daily basis, the minute we're put into this world until we leave this world, it's a trialing ground. And we have to try our best to do what is right. Do our best to do what is right and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us along that path. You see, in each one of our rak'ah, each one of our salah, we have to recite a verse from the Quran. And that verse is Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim, guide us unto the straight path, because we continuously need that guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continually need that guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because one day we may feel super energetic to do what is good. Some other days we may feel down, but we continue to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that connection to Him, especially in these moments of hardship. We look for that hope in our worship. We look for that happiness, that khushu, when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And only through the remembrance of Allah do our hearts find tranquility. Ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to be among those that when we wrong, that we recognize that we did something wrong, we acknowledge that we have done something wrong, and we ask Allah for forgiveness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from arrogance, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to let us put our hope in Him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to what is right, share us His mercy, and grant us and our families Jannatul Firdaus. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wassalamun ala al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Done.